Hello, everybody. It's me, Strategic Supremus, and this is part 7 of the United Analog series, or Belgium, whichever name you prefer, really. At the moment, we are. If you haven't seen the last episode, you really should. You wouldn't believe it if I told you that this happened. Let's just leave it at. Go watch that. Okay, now that everyone's left, we broke through. With a lot of help from the French and a little bit of Italians. That vast Italian army wasn't there yet. I don't know what it's doing there now. No idea. Anyway, basically the front collapsed and we were able to push through. But Germany took Russia out of the war first, so we have the Soviet Union in play now, which I don't feel good about. Frankly, Soviets in the universe basically ensured that there will be a Second World War. We're doing pretty well in the building so far. We are approaching Potsdam-Berlin. First, the game is mad to big, and slide on over. Should work pretty well. There's still this damn holdout in Malmedy. We'll work on that in this episode. Hopefully, we can finally take that shit. Anyway, I gotta go. Actually, I have time to start here. They're all trying to get to Western Germany. I want somebody over here in Eastern Germany just to give me some semblance of fighter coverage. Because I like having some semblance of fighter coverage. The game's getting really slow at high speed, which probably tells me I have to take it down a couple notches, which will not make me happy, but, you know, details. Alrighty, planes, what are you doing? Okay, we have air superiority in Western Germany. Eastern Germany, not Western Germany. Is this Southern Germany's Western Germany? What? We have air superiority in Berlin, but not Munich. All you need, though. We're going to try to be cheeky here and take things that they don't have yet. That they're not sitting, because they're busily trying to fall back to Munich over here. And then if we can get the takes and captures on Saarbrück and Strasbourg, well, we look a little bit better in terms of war score. Which we probably need a bit of. Yeah, we're at 8%. I'd like to be at least 10. I mean, we're a minor power, but, you know, Serbia's at 15, so, you know, fuck that. They've held on. I don't know how they've held on. It might take Sofia, too. Anyway, back to the front we actually care about. Well, let's go. Alright, maybe get a little better up there. 87. Yeah, this game has been tense lately. Actually finally managed to break through on this front, though, which is amazing. I almost didn't even think it was possible. It took the AI to be coordinated, which we all know the AI in Hearts of Iron is not so coordinated. Well, I'm being joined in this assault, am I not? Yeah, great, here we go. Let's just sneak on in and take territory. There we go. That's my capture, isn't it? Let's march. Right on down the Strasbourg's rear. Oh, why are you taking this for France? This is not French, this is Belgian. You bastards. We cannot join any French assault, so let's just move the front line cheekily back over here and focus our forces a little bit better. Because I'm not defending the French. They barely helped me. There. 82 in Magdeburg over here. We actually finally got rid of Malmedy. Thank you. Took you long enough, boys. And we'll get these guys back at the line shortly. Here we go. There we go. They'll get there. In sweet time. Doing alright here. I just want to take a quick look at something here. Find it. There it is. Supply area is. Oh boy. We're beginning to get slightly out of our supply line here because the infrastructure has been blown to hell by this little thing called World War I. And we're going to have to rebuild some of this. So let's just take a quick little look at our construction here. We should be pretty good. I mean, Thuringia is not that great. Luxembourg, not bad. Other than most of this is going to have to get repaired, I understand. Yeah, a lot of this is going to have to get repaired. Well, I'm going to just call in the construction when we finally get around constructing things again. And hope that they do a good job at repairing things. If you've been watching the series up to this point, please, you know, like, and or subscribe. It's been rather fun. I quite like this. There we go. What's over here? Strasbourg being taken properly. Well, come on, man. There we go. Damn French. Anyhow, I believe we're working on a doctrine effort. Yep. And we're trying not to push too much on this Berlin front, largely because I believe we're severely outnumbered on it. This one, however, we have an advantage. It's just falling to pieces. There we go. And that will take us and that will get us to the Swiss border, effectively cutting off whatever is left out over here, and setting me for the objective, also as Munich. While we're at it, let's just take one dude from right there. There we go. Yeah, there's Italians over here. Weird. It is 1915 and the war looks to be ending soon. Huh. A little bit faster than I suspected it would take. There's the French just wasting an hour. And why not? That being said, we only have 4,000 men left and I want to win the war before we run out. I mean, the French and Italians are coming, but I need no man. That did enough. Good. And the United States has joined the war. At long last. It took you guys long enough. Per usual, the US of A always joins the war when it's practically already been decided, and sort of just dumps manpower. Hopefully they'll land where I need them. As the Germans go on a last-ditch offensive along the Lüneburg border, and they're not going to really get it anymore. It is a last-ditch offensive. This is very clearly not going to work. We're at 94, 98 already. It's not happening. They tried. I probably ended up dying. Speaking of dying, let's see who's done the most so far. Our side, France, then Serbia, then United Kingdom, then us. Because all those are actually relatively very low. I was expecting at least somebody would have around 500,000, but no one does. I mean, if we add up the United Kingdom and all of their colonies and things, you might get there, but I'm surprised no one has a 500,000 on our side, considering we have nearly 3.5 million Germans dead, 1.2 million Austro-Hungarians dead, less than 50,000 Ottomans dead, only 12,000 Bulgarians dead, but there hasn't been very much Bulgarian war yet. And the Baltic Duchy and Lithuania have just joined in, as here's Lithuania. The United Baltic Duchy. They were created when the Germans beat the Russians. So it was the Ukraine. Beat the dubs. Although the Ukraine seems to be largely, they're authoritarian, but they're not part of the faction yet. Oh, that's White Russian. That's why. That's Russian Civil War stuff. My bad. That's the Ukrainian, fight against the Red Army. Yeah, that's gonna be entertaining. Anyway, back over here. I'm doing good. Holding them off there, pushing through down here. That's what we need to do. Let's just take the cheeky capture. Divide them up even more. Take them out of Strasbourg. And the French have just stopped helping on this side. On this side, not so much. Alrighty, we have air superiority when we need it. Just gonna check that then. Ah, appears to be a fleet battle. Convoys. Well, hopefully we'll get there in time. Guys, where's my navy? They're in dry docks, aren't they?
Yep.
I don't want to risk that. They want to lend lease me? I love that.
Oh, first things first.
Yeah, my production's been a little bit screwed up. That's weird. There. Okay, yeah. Just wondering why I didn't have enough airplanes. Anyway. Always need airplanes in this. Pretty sure it's the reason why we're surviving so far. I would love to get early motorized, but at the same time, I'm fairly certain we do not have the production capacity to actually do that. Remember, we don't have all that many factories. I mean, we finally have some factories. We are, however, not drowning them. I would like to be drowning them. Just what I want in life, you know? You can never have enough factories. Construction speed isn't bad. Supply consumption low would be nice. Let's go for heavy industry. Since it's 2 days. There we go. Yeah, we're researching 1916 techs in 1915 because we can. I would love it if the French actually got aggressive here with all of their damn men. And I'm pretty sure we're gonna have Americans showing up again soon. Because we already had volunteers. Sorry. Volunteers. Here already. And we were just waiting on. These guys really that dysfunctional? Oh. There we go, okay. We are at supply line, aren't we? That's not good. The Battle of Magdeburg just keeps on going. Not a good sign. Should the 1916 Olympics be cancelled? Pierre de Coubertin expressed his feelings concerning the 1916 Berlin gains in a letter to the Associated Press, echoing the sentiments of many 1916 Olympic Games may be impractical or impossible. Though many U.S. cities have offered to host the Games, instead, the International Olympic Committee must abide by its own rules and keep the site in Berlin. Perhaps there will be simply no Games this year. The committee wins gold in poor foresight. That being said, we might get to Berlin before then. Who knows? I can hope we do. This would be hilarious. That being said, we need to take Magdeburg first, because I just don't want that kind of a sound behind my advance. That would be bad. That means they can hit us from behind, and I really don't like that. There's nothing going on down here. Okay. Move on up. They've gotten the next level of hiding from me, which is not nice. Oh shit, they're actually trying to take something up here. They appear to have enough men to actually do something. That's not good. Get there. Come on, guys. Come on. Yeah, man. March, you little suckers. Ah, they take so long in the speed. There we go. We did our doctrinal effort. Let's make sure we have the man you can. So I have a feeling we'll eventually win this war, and I want to be able to pick that up for cheap. Because it's a nice province, and it should be mine. We're clearly. Let's move on to there. It won't let me now. It's attacking me. And I have a feeling we're about to lose this bit of an event, offensive, so I'm just going to retreat early. So we lose this map. Something about not wanting to get circled. Where I lose all those men. Just a quick losses. Yeah, nothing much to really change. Good enough. Is the United States gonna get here yet? Portuguese and French and Brits. I don't know if you've seen any Americans. I don't yet. Nope. Nope. Well, they shouldn't be in Africa. Over here, maybe? Nope. I don't see none. What are you taking me to do your sweet time getting here? Oh, no. They're all over there. That's it. That's a fleet. Huh. They're all still in the U.S., except for a couple. Huh. Interesting. Yeah, it does that sometimes. It's like, yeah, we're gonna join the war. Yeah, takes forever. We've lost our sailing in Potsdam, which annoys me. Seems like the Germans have finally actually picked up some defensive here, and the war might not be over by 1916. That being said, we are fighting entirely in Germany right now. Which makes me happy. I've done my job, at least. The war's not being fought in Belgium. Let's take that count. Come on, you pony. We've lost our superiority. Western dash, southern, whatever you want to call it, Germany. Well, that's not good. We need more planes. We just don't have any more planes. They all built airships and not fighters. Dumbass. Okay. Guys, you need fighters. Silly AI. Speaking of fighters. Research. Sorry if this one's a little bit less exciting than the previous one. We don't have a massive line break to spectate. But these things happen. That being said, we have set our gains pretty well here. Nothing's broken through again. We've gotten down through Saarbrücken, which they admit is Belgian. Haha! And, yeah, eventually we're going to have to hear Starstone or something along those lines. And let's just hope that this is enough Belgians to hold the border. Because everyone else seems to be running about. Shooting right ahead. Fucking AI. Okay. And there we go. Specific encirclement. It's been like 200 and something days, but it'll be worth it. Already. We're defending up there pretty well. This is going to be a loss. I don't like that very much, but I'll take what I can get, you know? That's going alright. It's not too bad. We still have men. Barely. Americans here yet? Nope. Japanese are here. Still no Americans. That's amazing. Send them up to the front. Might as well get on the line, you know? And we're holding up pretty well, which means the Germans are bleeding. See that ground just to get defense. Yeah, we're basically bleeding the German and Austro-Hungarian empires enough that they're slowly going to start losing. That being said, all those forces from the Eastern Front are showing up, which is why they're actually being able to make a push right now. Serbia seems to be doing what Serbia always does. The coalition forces and Dubrovnik and splits. Not bad, considering there's a horde coming at them. Probably going to lose Kim, which will push them back to split, which will not be good. The Italians are doing immaculately on the ground. They always end up doing so. Probably because the AI just doesn't understand. Only send Alpine troops here. No idea why. But yeah, if you're trying to do the Italian offensive and you're not sending in Alpinegros, you're gonna have a bad time. I don't see a single damn Alpinegro. What? You idiots. Well, you're Alpinegros. Down there. I suppose there's another place for them, it's just I'd rather have them up here. Because if you can take down to Trieste, and the rest of the goodness, Venice, and all this stuff, you hit a lot of war score. And you might be able to kick into the out of the war, because they have a lower unity than some countries. Then again, what is Serbia still doing here? What's Montenegro still doing here? Come on, guys. This is basically proving that the AI is not amazing at its job. But if it was, we'd all be doomed, so. That should bolster the defense. Luckily, these guys are all cut off, so they're not very likely to try anything offensive or break out, which is good. They will eventually get weakened enough that we can easily take out of Strasbourg. I'm not joining the French offensive, I'm going to Strasbourg and Belgium. If I can. Being said, if they take it, I don't give a shit. I don't lose. At the moment, at least. I don't know if I'll be able to actually claim all that anymore. I'm treated at the end of the war, so. Might just be part-time games. Except no Leipzig, so. We're almost at Leipzig. Hamburg is just not happening. This river is not being crossed. Not anytime soon, at least. We're coming up to the end of this episode, and I'd love to say a lot happened, but basically we just divided Germany a little more again. I think there's only going to be a couple more parts of this, because eventually we will hit Berlin. I'm only really going to show World War I at this, because the mod doesn't really encompass the interwar period all that well at the moment. They intend to. But it's just not quite all the way in here yet. Just because it takes time. Like I said, this is a small modding community, guys. This is not all the Paradox working on this. They do a good job, but it's not bad. I've enjoyed this so far. Immensely. I have a funny feeling that the Soviet Union is going to be the next problem. If that is to happen quickly, I was going for the series. If it doesn't, well, that's kind of the end, isn't it? We fought World War I, and World War II will take a long time to come here. And I'm pretty sure you guys don't want to see me spending 20 years just sort of mucking about preparing for a war that may or may not ever come. I suspect it will probably might not ever come. This might be the war to end all wars, when it might. Said the Germans are pushing through pretty well here. Still doing nothing on the Italian front. They have broken through two split down here, so this is not good for the Brits and the Italians and French and well, Montenegro and Serbia. That's not going to end well. So I'm going to pick my tech though. We're practically at 1916, so I want my helmet. I want my Lewis gun. Faster than Lewis gun. I want the Lewis gun. So yes, that's where we're going to have to leave you for this part. We've managed to solidify a breakthrough pretty well. We've lost a little bit of ground, but nothing catastrophic. It's not like this whole front just collapsed, which could have happened. That being said, our allies down in Eastern Europe, I guess, are having a bad time. Not the worst of times. That's probably being had by the Austrians trying to assault the Italians while they dug in the mountains.
Come on, yeah.
Anyway, thank you all for watching. Please like and or subscribe as you see fit. And I'll keep pumping out to the Belgians. Thanks, guys. See you in the next one.